Here we're going to discuss what are called the even and odd identities and the cofunction identities. So starting with the even and odd identities, let's first notice if you take cosine of pi over 3, that's equal to 1 half. But it's also true that cosine of negative pi over 3, you'll find that that's equal to 1 half as well. Now that's true for any angle. That is, cosine of negative of the angle is the same thing as cosine of just the angle. Now for sine, if you take, for example, sine of, let's say, 2 pi over 3, we know that that's equal to root 3 over 2. But if you take sine of negative 2 pi over 3, that's equal to negative root 3 over 2. So you get a negative output, or the opposite output, when you take the opposite input. So that's true for any angle with sine. That is, sine of the negative of the angle, that gives you the, or the opposite of the angle, gives you the opposite of the output of just sine of theta, or just the negative of sine of theta. Okay, so now what we're basically talking about in math is something called even versus odd. So when we say even in math, what we mean is that f of negative x is equal to just f of x. Okay, and the classic example of an even function would be x squared. And it's even because when you plug in negative x, you get x squared, which is just f of x. So in other words, changing the x to negative made no difference for the output. And an example of an even function is cosine. So cosine is even. Let's write that down. And likewise, secant is even. Now that's not super surprising because secant is the reciprocal of cosine. Now we have odd functions as well. And odd functions are functions where when you plug in negative x, you get the negative of f of x. Okay? And a classic example of an odd function would be x cubed. And that's because if you plug in negative x, you get negative of x cubed. That is, you get the negative of f of x. And sine, of course, is an example of an odd function. So sine is an odd function, and so is its reciprocal, that is cosecant. Now the question is, what about tangent and cotangent? Turns out they are both odd as well. So tangent is odd, and so is cotangent. Okay, so all of the six trig functions are either even or odd. The only two even functions are cosine and secant. All the others are odd. So before we see how to make use of these identities, these are the even and odd identities, before we see how to make use of them in other to simplify other expressions, let's go ahead and see what that says about the graphs of these functions, even or odd. So on the left here, I have the even, or two even functions. And on the right, I have two odd functions. Notice that over here, if I take x, right, and then I take negative x, notice that the output, that is the y-coordinate, is the same in both cases. Okay, in both cases, I get that value if I plug in x or negative x. That's a reflection of the fact that the function is even. No matter if you plug in x or negative x, you get the same output. And cosine, it's also true, right? If you plug in x, or if you plug in negative x, it doesn't matter. You're still going to get the same output. In this case, this might be the y-coordinate in both cases. So what that leads to is the fact that this branch of the function looks like the other branch. That it's, this branch is a mere reflection across the y-axis of that branch. And the same thing is true with cosine, right? Across the y-axis, if you reflect this branch, you get the other branch. So that's always true for even functions, that the graphs are mere reflections across the y-axis. So mere reflections across the y-axis. But for odd functions, that's certainly not true. This branch is not a mere reflection of this branch across the y-axis. But notice that if this is x and this is negative x, right, the output that you get, that is, you know, the y value here, if you plug in negative x, the y value might be down here. And the relationship is that this is the negative of that. And the same thing is true with sine, that if you have x and you also plug in here, you know, negative x, that the output that you get when you plug in negative x, which is down here, is the negative of what you plugged in when you the output that you got when you plugged in positive x. So the consequence of this is that is as follows. Let's look at this graph right here. Imagine there was a pin through the origin like so. If you rotate this branch 180 degrees, that's going to land right here. It's going to land on this branch. But if you take this branch and you rotate it 180 degrees, it'll land on that branch. So the same thing is true with sine, right? Imagine giving this branch a spin, you know, woo, it spins, and then this one spins, and you basically can't tell that the graph hasn't been changed at all because each branch has fallen where the previous one was. And so what we say is that these graphs, that is odd functions, have symmetry about the origin. So symmetry about the origin. And we think of that as symmetry about 180 degree rotation about the origin. Okay, now that we know that we understand how even and odd functions look graphically, let's go ahead and work with them to establish or to simplify expressions. So let's first simplify tangent of negative x multiplied by cosine of x. Now, tangent, of course, is odd, which means that tangent of negative x is equal to negative of tangent of x. That's the whole point, right? That's what happens with an odd function, that when the input is negative, or when you take the opposite of something, when you take the opposite of an input, you get the opposite of what you would have had for the original output. And people think of this practically like as if the negative kind of came through the function, and that's fine to think of it like that. Tangent, of course, is sine over cosine. And then we can leave cosine as cosine over 1, and the cosines cancel, and you just get negative sine. And this would be our answer. This has been simplified. Okay, for the next one, we want to write in the form y equals a times sine of b times x minus c plus d. And we want to write this in that form. So the first thing I notice is that the b has been factored out, and I have a coefficient of 1 right there. So that's what I'm going to do here. I'm going to factor out the negative 2 within the parentheses. So I get y is equal to 3 times sine of, it's going to be negative 2 times x minus pi over 4. Let's just check that that's right. Now, I have to distribute that negative 2, right? So negative 2 times x is negative 2x. And a negative 2 times a negative pi over 4, first of all, the negatives cancel to give me positive. And then 2 times pi over 4 is pi over 2. Now, sine is odd. And because it's a product, that is, because it's multiplication right here, I can regard this negative as a factor of negative 1. And because sine is an odd function, it's like the negative comes through, and we get this. Y is equal to negative 3 sine of 2 times x minus pi over 4. And this would be my answer, because it's been written in that form. Now, it turns out that there are some other identities that we're going to find useful. Let's take a look at those now. These are called the cofunction identities. So first of all, two angles are called complementary if they add to be 90 degrees. So for example, 30 degrees and 60 degrees, they add to be 90, so they're called complementary angles. Now, notice that sine of 30 degrees is equal to cosine of 60 degrees. Now, that word cosine, if you write it out, looks like this. And the little CO is telling you that cosine and sine are what we call cofunctions. So that little co tells you you're looking at a function that has a cofunction. Now, it turns out what's important is that, or what's true is that, a trig function of an angle is always equal to its cofunction of the complement. So for example, if you take tangent of 40 degrees, right, that's equal to cotangent, that is its cofunction of the complement. And so what would this angle have to be? Well, these angles would have to be 90, right? So this would be 50 degrees. And it's also true, as you can verify, that secant for example, of, let's say, 21 degrees, that's equal to cosecant, that it's co, that is its cofunction, cosecant of, it's going to be 69 degrees, because these two angles add to be 90 degrees. Now, if you write this generally, let's go back to sine for a minute, and you write this, sine of A, okay, that's equal to cosine. Now, what would this angle have to be? Well, how did you get these angles previously? Didn't you get 69 degrees, didn't you simply subtract 21 from 90? So whatever, to get this angle, you always just have to take that angle and subtract it from 90. So this is going to be 90 degrees, take away A. So usually we don't write 90 degrees though. Usually we write the angle in terms of radians. So it's true that sine of A generally is cosine of, that's going to be pi over 2, right? Take away A. And the same is true with tangent. Tangent of A is going to be cotangent of pi over 2, take away A. And then finally, secant of A is equal to cosecant of pi over 2, that is basically 90, take away A again. These identities are called the cofunction identities. Cofunction identities. And so the functions sine and cosine, those are cofunctions. Same with tangent and cotangent, and secant and cosecant. So cofunctions come in pairs. Now it also goes the other way, for example, that sine of pi over 2 minus A is just equal to cosine of A. So in other words, the pi over 2 minus A might be on the right of the equation, or it might be on the left. And the same thing is true with these next two equations as well. Okay, let's see where you make use, or where we're going to make use of the cofunction identities on occasion. So let's say we wanted to simplify cotangent of pi over 2 minus x. Well, what's important to see is that you have this, right? Basically 90 minus x, pi over 2 take away x. And once I see that, I think about cofunctions. And the cofunction of cotangent, of course, is tangent. So this is the same thing as just tangent of x times cosecant of x. And then, of course, tangent is sine of x divided by cosine x. And then cosecant of x is 1 over sine x. Now the sine x's cancel, and you get 1 over cosine. And that's just equal to secant x. Okay, so here we've seen how to make use of the even and odd identities and also the cofunction identities. And we're also going to make use of those later on when we establish identities, generally speaking. Okay, until next time.